Students, welcome to Plus One Political Science class. Today, I will start Lesson 4, Political Ideologies. It has four ideologies, Liberalism, Socialism, Communism and Fascism. The objectives of today's class are Liberalism, its meaning and definition, Classical Liberalism and Contemporary Liberalism, Basic principle of liberalism. Before discussion of these objectives, I would like to discuss the keywords with you. The first keyword is liberalism. It means philosophy based on liberty and consent of the governed. Cold War, the state of hostility between the Soviet bloc and Western powers from 1945 to 1990. Students, those who have done ICSC class 10th, they have done this Cold War topic in detail in history topic. Socialism, theory that means of production and distribution to be regulated by community. Rule of law, restriction on the arbitrary exercise of power. Rational, based on logic. Transparency, not to hide anything. Now I will discuss today's topic, that is liberalism, meaning and definition. It is given on your chapter pages 80 till 84. Now students, the term liberalism has just now been discussed with you, and I have also discussed the topic, the origin of the state, in detail with you. Ever since the origin of the state, liberalism has been an ideology. In all periods of history, liberalism has been advocated as an ideology which stood for the rights and freedoms and interests of the individuals. It has been defined differently in different periods of history. Initially, it was called individualism. Later on, it got the name modern individualism. At present, in the 21st century, it is known as contemporary liberalism. So students, you see here, liberalism has been a part of the state since its origin. Now liberalism was a base of both French Revolution and the American War of Independence. In England also, liberalism assumed the status of national ideology in the Glorious Revolution in the 18th century. These topics, French Revolution, American War of Independence and Glorious Revolution, you have done in detail in your junior classes. So this is all about the 18th century. Now I will talk about the 20th century. In the 20th century, many Asian and African nations worked to overthrow the imperialism, and for their independent status they worked. These liberation movements got strengthened from the ideologies of liberalism and socialism. Today, liberalism is universally accepted and followed ideology of the world. Now, I will tell you the origin of the word liberalism. Liberalism word is originated from the Latin word, that is the liberalis. It means the word freeman. So, liberalis means the freeman. Liberalism stands for the social, economic and political order wherein man may feel free and get encouraged to develop without any outside interference. So man is not to be interfered from outside. So according to political thinker Lasky, liberalism is no doubt related to the freedom. So are you clear? So such a definition and quotations you must write in your notes as well as in your exams to score better. So I can say you that liberalism preserves individual rights and freedoms. Is it clear? So right from its beginning times and ancient time to the present time, liberalism has been continuously undergoing important changes. We can identify it into two broad forms. First is classical liberalism and second is contemporary liberalism. First, I will explain you the classical liberalism. Classical liberalism, to understand this concept, I will tell you, classical liberalism was an original form of liberalism, or you can say another name is individualism. As I told you in the beginning, its earlier name was individualism. It supported a limited government based on the consent of the people. The classical liberalist supported the doctrine of natural rights of individual and considered the society as a mere collection of individuals. It desired minimum control of state upon the individual. Students, listen carefully. It even advocated that, it said that government is the best which governs the least. That government is best which governs the least. In economic sphere, it supported the idea of laissez faire. Students, listen it carefully. It's a very important ideology. Laissez faire means least amount of state interference in the economic life of the people. It also supported open competition in the trade. So there are two things: least state interference and open competition in the trade. These are the two things in the classical liberalism. So are you clear about the classical liberalism? So I have discussed about the classical liberalism. Now I will discuss the contemporary liberalism. Due to the ideology of laissez-faire, the classical liberalism, there was least amount of state interference in the economic life of the people. I hope you can imagine its result. Just think about the situation when the economic activities are not checked by the state. Just imagine, because it's written as least state interference. Imagine when state is not interfering in the economic activities, what will be the result? Okay, I will tell you. The classical liberalism enabled the capitalist to exploit the working classes to the maximum. Means capitalist class became very strong and they started exploiting the working class. And this reduced the workers to the level of extreme poverty. Due to the policy of open competition in business, the money got concentrated in the hands of few persons and it resulted in economic inequality in the society. Here is open competition in the trade and this resulted in the economic inequality in the society. So these two points resulted in these two points. Least state interference resulted in the capitalist exploitation of the workers and open competition in trade resulted in the economic inequality in the society. So this was all in the 19th century. But during the 20th century, liberalism was associated with the concept of welfare state. Scholars like Lasky were of the view that it would only be with the interference of the state that social and political conditions could be reformed. So, you see students, state plays an important role in liberalism. In the 20th century, liberalism had established a world free from all kinds of exploitations. Now, liberalism is the best ideology in the present world. Hope you are clear about the contemporary liberalism. Now, I will discuss the basic principles of liberalism. The first principle of liberalism is recognition of importance of individual. It means individuals make the society. There is nothing without individual. So, individual is accepted as a central point of all political, social and economic activities. Liberalism provides high position and importance to the individual. Is it clear? So, individual has high position according to liberalism. And the second point is faith in rationality of individual. The supporters of liberalism lay stress on the organized intellectual power of human as the basis of all human progress and development. The reason is that every individual knows well what is good for him and what is not good for him. Man is a rational animal. Being rational is God-gifted, and this is given to him by the God. And this is the main point discussed here. Is it clear? It is due to this rationalism only. Liberalists had a little faith in superstitions and irrational traditions. It is due to all this, we consider that we are living in modern age. We use our brain to accept anything. Hope you are clear about this point also. Now, I will discuss the next point. Support for human rights and freedoms. Liberals support human rights and freedoms, like Indian Constitution provides fundamental rights. These are the basic human rights and freedoms. The liberals support these rights and freedoms. Liberals support these rights because these are fundamentals. It's a state's duty to provide these rights and protect these rights. Like in India, our rights are protected by High Courts and Supreme Court of India. And we feel we are safe. Students, we have done all this in detail up in junior classes also. You know well which fundamental right protects our all other fundamental rights. It's right to constitutional remedies which protect all other fundamental rights. So we can move to High Court or Supreme Court to protect our fundamental rights. Next is constitutional and limited government. Liberalism is opposed to absolutism of the rulers. It's not that ruler may do anything anytime. Now the thing is, the rulers has the powers, but the rulers are not to use these powers unlimited. They are to use these powers limited. It favors the limiting the powers of the government. Means that the government should also work within the constitutional limits. Students, you also know that the definition of the constitution, it is a set of rules and regulations for the working of the government. So, the government should work within the framework of constitution. Liberalism believes in the boundaries of the constitution and boundaries of the government. Like, we work within the limits of the laws, and the government works within the limits of the constitution. Not only this, liberalism believes in the secularism also. Where there is no state religion like India, there is no religion, there is equality of all the religions. We don't have any state religion like our neighboring countries like Nepal. You know the national religion of Nepal, what is that? That is Hinduism. And what is the national religion of Pakistan? That is Islam. But India, there is no national religion, we are secular. And finally, I will tell you, faith in internationalism and universal brotherhood. Students, we are not to be narrow nationalist. Be liberal in outlook. Means, liberalism supports internationalism. That is world peace and brotherhood of all the people. Liberalism believes in motto, that is Live and let live means jio or jine do. It supports the rights of every state to develop irrespective of its size or resources. It stands for world peace, internationalism and globalization. Students, hope you are clear about the principles of liberalism. You must revise the topic from the given pages and watch the video again. Do the snap over questions. Tomorrow I will discuss the next topic. Till then, goodbye and thank you.